Our epistle this evening is taken from the first letter of Blessed Paul the Apostle to the Thessalonians. Brethren, even as you have learned from us how you ought to walk and to please God, as indeed you are walking, we beseech and exhort you in the Lord Jesus that you make even greater progress. For you know what precepts I have given you by the Lord Jesus. For this is the will of God, your sanctification, that you abstain from immorality, that every one of you learn how to possess his vessel in holiness and honor, not in the passion of lust like the Gentiles who do not know God, that no one transgress and overreach his brother in the matter, because the Lord is the avenger of all these things. As we have told you before and we have testified, for God has not called us unto uncleanliness, but unto holiness in Christ Jesus our Lord. Let us stand for the Holy Gospel. A continuation of the Holy Gospel according to Saint Matthew. At that time Jesus took Peter, James, and his brother John and led them up a high mountain by themselves, and was transfigured before them. And his face shone as the sun, and his garments became white as snow. And behold, there appeared to them Moses and Elias talking with him. When Peter addressed Jesus, saying, Lord, it is good for us to be here. If thou wilt, let us set up three tents here, one for thee, one for Moses, and one for Elias. And as he was still speaking, behold, a bright cloud overshadowed them. And behold, a voice out of the cloud said, This is my beloved Son, in whom I am well pleased. Hear him. And on hearing it, the disciples fell on their faces and were exceedingly afraid. And Jesus came near and touched them and said to them, Arise, do not be afraid. But lifting up their eyes, they saw no one but Jesus only. And as they were coming down from the mountain, Jesus cautioned them, saying, Tell the vision to no one, till the Son of Man has risen from the dead. Please be seated. Here are some announcements. Our masses this week are as usual, 6:15 in the morning at 6 o'clock in the evening. However, tomorrow morning, 10:30 in the morning, the women's retreat will start. So 10:30. Please, retreatants, come on time. Latecomers will not be accepted. It will be refunded. Okay? Because of this retreat, let us observe silence around our church and priory. On Wednesday evening, there will be no perpetual health novena because of this retreat. However, on Friday, our Stations of the Cross will start at 5:20 in the evening, and this will be concluded with a blessing with the relic of the True Cross. On Saturday is the feast of Saint Joseph, husband of the Blessed Virgin Mary. So Saturday evening, we will have a sung mass. Now, although the weather is getting hotter, still let us observe modesty in our clothing. Ladies, please avoid wearing pants or sleeveless or see-through blouses. Gentlemen, kindly refrain from using tight pants and large printed t-shirts, especially their very secular designs. In receiving Holy Communion, please, everyone, there is no need to answer Amen. It's the priest praying for you. But do stick out your tongue, tilt your head, and please don't bite the priest's fingers. We don't want to share rabies to one another. Okay, so tongues out, head tilted, like this. Okay? On weekdays of Lent, there is a special prayer after communion. The priest will say, Humiliati Capita Vestra Deo. During that last prayer, we bow down our heads before the final blessing. And then lastly, on the 27th of March, all the members of the Legion of Mary, both active and auxiliaries, will have their acties starting 1:30 in the afternoon. So thank you very much for your attention and cooperation. The name of the Father, the Son, of the Holy Ghost. Amen. Dear friends, if you remember, last Sunday, our Lord Jesus Christ showed us how to fight the devil. But today, he gives us a glimpse of that reward which he has prepared for us, the participation of his glory. Unfortunately, we continue to fall into the devil's temptation and sin. And that is why our Lord instituted for us the sacrament of penance, to help us practice the virtue of penance perfectly. But before approaching the sacrament of penance or confession, we must first examine our conscience. And the first act of this sacrament of penance is called contrition, to break our hearts, not our heads, to break our hearts away from sin and its occasion. And last Sunday, you remember, we know that there are two qualities of this contrition. It must be interior, and it must be appreciatively supreme. Today, let us discover three other qualities of contrition or attrition which are reflected in our Lord's transfiguration, namely universal, supernatural, and humble. You've just heard Jesus took Peter, James, and his brother John to a high mountain and was transfigured before them. Our Lord's face shone like the sun, even his clothes become white as snow. And then Moses and Elias appeared and talked to him about his departure in Jerusalem. So here in the transfiguration of our Lord, we've seen the universality of divine revelation. And at the center of that revelation is Jesus Christ himself, God who became man. The Old Testament is represented by Moses and Elias, the law and the prophets. The New Testament is represented by these three principal apostles, Saint Peter, the first pope, Saint James, the first apostle to become a martyr, and Saint John, the virgin apostle. Similarly, dear friends, our contrition must be universal, meaning we must be sorry for all our sins, not just for some of them. All our mortal sins especially. Why? Because one mortal sin kills the life of God in our souls. It takes away sanctifying grace from our souls. You see, to be sorry for some mortal sins, but not for all of them, is like choosing between eating a liputa mushroom. Sa Tagalog, kakain ba kayo ng kabuting gubat? Okay. Wala sa atin dito ang kakain ng butete, di ba? The puffer fish. Wala rin sa atin dito ang kakain ng kamuting kahoy sa gubat, wild cassava. Why? Because all of them is poisonous. Similarly, all mortal sins kills our soul. Consequently, we cannot be sorry for some mortal sins, but not for all of them. They kill our souls. In same time, we cannot confess some mortal sins, but hide the others. See? Bless me, Father, for I am sin. Father, I am sorry na nagnakaw ako. But I'm not sorry na nangirida ako. You're not sorry at all. With mortal sins, dear friends, it is either we are sorry for all of them or we are not sorry at all. We cannot choose. Now here, St. Peter proposed three tents, one for our Lord, one for Moses, and one for Elias. And St. Peter wanted to remain there, enjoying this stupendous vision of our Lord's transfiguration, of our Lord's glory. But Jesus did not answer him. Instead, the voice of God the Father was heard. "This is my beloved Son, listen to him." And the Holy Ghost manifested himself in this bright cloud that enveloped them. Now tell me, what is more supernatural than this divine theophany, wherein the three divine persons of the Blessed Trinity showed himself distinctly? Likewise, our contrition needs to be supernatural. It must be elicited by the aid of divine grace, not merely by our natural powers. Our contrition, its motive must be supernatural also, based on a truth or a fact which is known through the light of faith, not just by natural reason like being shameful or financial loss. No. This reminds me, in 2007, I was still assigned in Africa. I was assigned in 2006 to 2008 in Zimbabwe, Harare. Now, in Zimbabwe, Harare, there was their biggest hospital. Its name is Pararenyatwa General Hospital. Now, our Legion of Mary members there in Zimbabwe were doing visitation of the sick in this hospital. So during their visitation, two patients from the AIDS ward wanted to go to confession. However, before confessing, the older patient, he was about 48 years old, told me, "How, Baba, I am rather old now. I am going to die and meet God soon. So, Baba, I want to settle my accounts with God now so that when I die, at least He will be merciful to me." But the younger patient, he was only 23 years old, confided, "Baba, I'm afraid to die. What would my parents, my family and friends would say if I die of AIDS?" So you see, the older patient have a supernatural motive, but the younger one, a purely natural motive of human respect. What would others say if I die of AIDS? So after this, I asked the legionaries to pray more for that younger patient so that he will have a supernatural motive. Otherwise, I cannot give him holy absolution. Continuing, the three apostles, having heard the voice of the Eternal Father, were exceedingly afraid. They fell on their faces on the ground, both for fear and adoration of God. Surely, we can easily sympathize with them. Like yesterday afternoon, there was this rain, there was this great thunder and lightning. We're already afraid of that. How much more for them? They heard the voice of God Himself. So to calm them down, Jesus came and touched them, bidding them to stand up. But when they lifted their eyes, they only saw Jesus. In like manner, their friends, let us also, when we are truly sorry for our sins, fall down before the Lord. Not just in our body by kneeling down, but most of all in our souls. To fall down before the Lord is the fifth And the last authentic quality of contrition, it's called humility. Now, the word humility comes from the Latin humus, which means the ground, and stabilitas, steadiness or stability. By humility, we fall down on the ground. We acknowledge that God is everything and that we are nothing. By humility, we live with our feet firmly on the ground. We don't pretend to be angels. Firmly on the ground, and we avow our total dependence on God. In Him, we live, we move, and we are. And this is the quintessential metaphysical truth which the church reminded us last Ash Wednesday when we are given the blessed ashes. Remember, man, that you are dust, and unto dust you shall return. Indeed, by one mortal sin, we who are but dust and ashes dare to insult Almighty God. That is mortal sin, to insult God in His face. So our contrition must be humble, because we offended the Lord of infinite majesty. And He's not only our Lord, He is our loving and merciful Father, who until this very moment, has been patient and merciful to us. We could have died of COVID and go immediately to hell. We could have had an accident on the road coming to Our Lady Victory's Church. But no, God prevented that. No, dear friends, we cannot and we must not brag of our sins. You see, nothingness is incapable of offending God. But we are still capable of offending Him. So by sinning, by repeating our sins, we make ourselves less than nothing. By sinning, we make ourselves less than nothing. Anyhow, the three apostles went down the mountain with Jesus. Like them, our humility should not be only in theory. Oh, very nice sermon of Father Saa yesterday. It must be also in practice this week. Let us go down with Jesus from the joy and glory of Tabor to the sorrow and the humiliation of Calvary. Our prayers, dear friends, should urge us this Lent to charitable words and charitable works. Charitable words and charitable works. Yes. Moreover, our Lord told them, tell the vision to no man until the Son of Man has risen from the dead. Even these charitable words and works must be done discreetly, not to be seen by man. Oh, meron akong abuloy, pero selfie muna. No, discreetly. And that's why, unlike in the Novus Ordo churches, here at Our Lady of Victories, when we confess our sins, dun sa likod, we kneel down beside the priest. And that kneeling down is the exteriorization of our humble confession. We don't brag our sins. And when we kneel down, we don't need to exaggerate our sins. Neither should we put too much details or make others wait too long for their turn to confess. You know, kapag ang kasalanan niyo ay venial sins lang, you don't have to confess every Sunday. Once every 2 weeks or every fortnight, that's enough to give others the chance to go to confession. And even the priest, we don't have to know everything. All we need to know is your specific sins, the number of times you committed them, or at least approximate frequency of committing them. Remember, only those details that changes the malice of your sin must be added. For example, it is not enough to say, "Father, I've stolen something, a sacred object," when in fact, what you've stolen is a consecrated chalice. Because aside from a sin against the virtue of justice in stealing, there is also a sin against the virtue of religion, which is sacrilege. Nonetheless, as Saint Francis de Sales remarked, "Those humilities which we see the least are the finest humilities. Those humilities that other people see the least are the finest humilities. Discretion is humility in action. Tell the vision to no one." Therefore, our Lord's Transfiguration portrays the three other qualities of a true contrition or attrition. The Old Testament, represented by Moses and Elias, the New Testament by Saints Peter, James, and John, and Jesus at the middle of them. That is the universality of divine revelation. Similarly, our contrition must be universal. We must be sorry for all our mortal sins, not just for some of them. Otherwise, it is like choosing which poisonous food shall I taste today. Next, there was the supernatural theophany, the three divine persons manifesting themselves distinctly. Likewise, our contrition must be supernatural in its principle, meaning prompted by God's grace, and supernatural in its motive, meaning it is known by the light of faith. The fear of hell is supernatural already, but human respect, ano kayang sabihin, magiging voice of chismis na naman ako, that does not count. Then, having heard the voice of the Father, the apostles fell on the ground. In like manner, our contrition should make us fall on the ground before the infinite majesty of God whom we have offended. Our contrition must be humble. It is sheer madness to brag of our sins. And yet, many people still do it in the FB, in the TikToks, etc., bragging their sins. Pride is the root of sin. Humility is the beginning of salvation. This week, let us practice discretion, which is humility in our words and in our actions. So, the five qualities of contrition or attritions are interior and supreme, universal, supernatural, and humble. So may the Blessed Virgin Mary and Saint Joseph obtain for us a true and lasting contrition for all our sins, so that after our short life here on earth, we may be transfigured into that glory of our Lord Jesus Christ in heaven. Amen. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Ghost. Amen.